But first, the future of Railroad Square up in the air. We are sitting down with one of its owners for a frank discussion of what needs to happen for the Art District to return following terrible storms. Thank you for joining us at 6 tonight. I'm Julie Montanaro.
And I'm Jacob Murphy. One of the tornadoes blew right through Railroad Square, damaging many of the businesses. The owners are now asking for investment from the city and county.
Our Stacey Inez talked with one of the owners today. Stacey, what did they tell you about trying to get more support?
Yeah, well, Julie and Jacob, of course, while the storm is making this and the damage also that came with it, it's making this discussion more relevant right now. Lily Kay, one of the co-owners, says they've been trying to get this type of support as far back as 2007 to help make Railroad Square more sustainable for the community. Now, she says at this point, this partnership is something that needs to happen.
Just like city parks are funded by the government, the art district needs to be supported in some way by government funding because it is a public resource.
Lily Kay says seeking ownership from other sources is not a bailout, but an investment in the capital city's art district.
Government and nonprofits can provide art studios and spaces for creative entrepreneurs in a way that a for-profit business can't. And so we've been doing it, but there's better ways to do it, and there's better ways to ensure the longevity and the sustainability of Railroad Square.
On top of that, recent storms left many buildings damaged, and none of them had property insurance. But Kay says that was to allow more business owners the opportunity to have a space in the district.
Some of the buildings are too old, and the way that they're made is not insurable. And other buildings could be insurable, but the expense of it would put us in a situation where we wouldn't be able to keep the rents as affordable as they are for creative entrepreneurs and artists.
Kay says right now she and her brother Adam have been running the district by themselves with a small staff since their mother passed away years ago.
It is a lot to provide Tallahassee's art district, and we really need some other entities to get involved to usher Railroad Square forward past this disaster into the next phase of Tallahassee's art district.
Yeah, Kay tells me really the ultimate goal here is just to help these entrepreneurs and also get that backing so the district itself can become more successful. She told me in conversation earlier today that this is not just a place where people come and hang out, but it's also an economic driver for the city and also for tourism as well. And that's why they're hoping to get more of those outside investments. We're now live here in Railroad Square. Stacey Inez, WCTV Eyewitness News.
All right, this is a dialogue we'll keep our eyes on. Stacey, thank you.